everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. I am Nuzhat Sana. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GK Today Academy app. You can attend the quizzes on this app for better practice. And after that, you can also read the detailed explanation of the questions you have missed. For regular updates, please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay. Also, our latest initiative is UPSC Prelims Test Series for 2021 and 2022 in GK Today Academy app. So if you are appearing in UPSC prelims, you may consider joining this. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started. So today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 1st of July 2021. Starting with very first question, which union ministry implements the Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan? So this is implemented by our Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So recently, Union Social Justice Minister has launched the website for Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan, and it is also the nodal ministry for drug demand reduction in India. Apart from it, few days back, Thawar Chand Gehlot has launched the SAGE project. What is SAGE? Senior Care Aging Growth Engine. So this project aims to select, support and also create one-stop access of elder care products and services, which is to be provided by credible startups. Then there is one more app from this ministry, Saugamya Bharat app, and it is a type of crowdsourcing mobile application which has been developed to enhance the accessibility under the Accessible India campaign. So as we know that this campaign has three pillars, first of all in transportation sector, then second is to build environment, and third is ICT ecosystem in India. And also, 2-3 lectures back, we have talked that Social Justice Ministry is to set up Divyangata Khel Kendras. Why? To work towards interest of Divyangjans in sports and to improve their good performance in Paralympics. Can you tell me when do we celebrate World Elder Abuse Awareness Day? And one hint is, this day comes in last month. Please write in the comment section if you know. Question number 2. What is the theme of the International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking 2021? First of all, we celebrate this day on 26th of June. And this day is observed worldwide to strengthen action and cooperation in achieving sustainable world free of substance abuse. So theme for this year was Share Facts on Drugs, Save Lives. So the campaign highlights key statistics and data drawn from UNODC's yearly World Drug Report. Apart from it, we celebrate our International Olympic Day on 23rd of June. Why? To promote the participation in sports across the globe, irrespective of their age, gender or athletic ability. Then International Day of Celebration of Solstice is on 21st of June, which is the same day for International Day of Yoga itself. So there was an application which was launched few days before the yoga day. It was called as Namaste Yoga. Can you tell me this was launched by which ministry? Please write in the comment section if you know. Then we celebrate World Refugee Day on 20th of June. And this year theme was Together We Heal, Learn and Shine. Then we celebrate International Day for Elimination of Sexual Violence in Conflict on 19th of June. Then there is Bicycle Day, which was celebrated on 3rd of June. Then Milk Day celebrated on 1st of June. So these are the important days in the month of June. Now you have to tell me, when do we celebrate World Environment Day and what was the theme for this year also. Question number 3. Which state has recently dropped interviews for all recruitments in government jobs? So recently the Andhra Pradesh government has issued a formal order to dispense with the process of interviews for all the future recruitments into government services. So now this new system calls for only written examinations, and this process would be conducted for all the categories of post including Group 1 services. So this step has been taken to maintain transparency and ensure trust of the competing candidates in the selection process. Now Andhra Pradesh was also in news because recently IBRD, means International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, has sanctioned funds of 1860 crore rupees to implement the SALT program. What is SALT? It is Supporting Andhra's Learning Transformation. So this program basically aims to improve learning outcomes, then quality of teaching practices, and school management in basic education. Also, Andhra Pradesh has decided to set up India's first government-run ambulance network for the animals. So this decision has been taken in order to further boost the animal husbandry as well as veterinary sector in the state. Then Andhra Pradesh is also the second state to implement the power sector reforms that was put forward by Department of Expenditure, which comes under Ministry of Finance. Question number 4, grey list which was sometimes seen in the news is associated with which institution? So it's a very obvious question. It is related to FATF, that is Financial Action Task Force. So actually FATF is an intergovernmental organization founded in 1989, and it was the initiative of G7 countries to develop various type of policies to combat especially two things. First is money laundering and second is terrorism funding. So it has mainly two lists. First is your grey and second is blacklist. What is the difference between the two? First of all, let's talk about the blacklist. So those countries that are supporting the terror funding and money laundering activities are placed in this list. So they are called as non-cooperative countries. Then talking about grey list, those countries which are not considered as the safe for supporting the terror funding and money laundering comes under this category. So the inclusion in this list is not severe as the black one. So if any country comes under the grey list, it means that it is a type of warning that it might come in a black list as well if it does not stop doing these activities, okay? So if you are in grey list, you may come out of it, but if you are in black list, then it's very difficult for you to come out. And recently we have seen that Pakistan, which is in grey list of FATF, has suffered with $38 billion loss. The headquarters of FATF is at Paris, which is in France. Apart from it, talking about G7, G7 meeting was recently presided by United Kingdoms. And can you name the countries which were the guest leaders in this summit? Please write in the comment section if you know. So why this is in news? Because recently FATF has added few countries in its grey list. And which are they? Malta, Haiti, Philippines, and South Sudan. And Pakistan is already there. And also please remember that Ghana has been removed from this list because it showed some type of progress, okay? So whenever FATF places a country into grey list, it means the country is subject to increased monitoring. So FATF is a type of global watchdog for money laundering as well as terror financing. Question number 5. Abhishek Verma, who recently won a gold medal for India, is associated with which sports? So recently Abhishek Verma has created history by becoming the first man ever to win 2 World Cup gold medals in individual compound. So earlier he had won the gold at the individual event in Rokla in 2015, and recently he has won the second gold in men's individual compound event at Archery World Cup Stage 3, which was being held in Paris. So he is related to your archery. Apart from it, recently veteran athlete Milkha Singh has passed away due to COVID-19, and do remember that he is the only athlete who has won gold in 400 meters race at Asian Games as well as Commonwealth Games. Then already we have talked about Laurel Hubbard. Why this name is important? Because she is the first ever transgender athlete to compete at Olympics this time. And since Laurel does not qualify the important criteria which was needed to compete in men's category, and that's why now she will be fighting in women's category. And obviously she belongs to New Zealand. Also recently, New Zealand has won the inaugural ICC World Test Championship finals, and with this, it has become the first World Test champion. And also recently, Olympic theme tune for the Indian contingent has been launched, and Mohit Chauhan, who is Indian playback singer, has composed it as well as sung it. Question number 6, Itate Dwar, which was in the news recently, is a portal launched by which institution? So this is a e-filing portal of ITAT, means Income Tax Appellate Tribunal. So this newly developed e-filing portal would enable the parties to file their appeals or some type of documents or paper books or any type of miscellaneous applications in the electronic mode. So this portal will enhance the accessibility and transparency in the working of ITAT. Now recently, India cuts the crude palm oil import tax from 15% to 10% for next 3 months. So this new tax rate would be effective from 30th of June now. And also recently, Ministry of Electronics and IT has released the list of digital payment scorecard. And in this scorecard, SBI has topped for the third consecutive term. And this scorecard tracks the performance of the commercial banks on several digital parameters. Question number 7. As per the Finance Ministry's notification, what is the limit of tax exemption on COVID treatment expenses if received from other person? So as per the Finance Ministry's recent notification, tax on expenses which have been incurred on COVID-19 treatment of an employee borne by the employers or any other person is exempted. And this exemption is applicable to any amount paid by the employer, and it is limited to 10 lakh rupees if it is received from any other person. So this covers the treatment of COVID-19 during financial year 20 and the subsequent years. Apart from it, few months back, T.V. Somanathan has been designated as the finance secretary by the appointments committee of the cabinet. Then there is a campaign from Delhi, Jahan Vote Wahan Vaccination. So under this campaign, people with age of 45 years or 45 plus, they can directly get the vaccination done on their respective polling stations. And also Delhi has launched one more Yojana called Mukhyamantri COVID-19 Parivar Arthik Sahayata Yojana. And under this, it will provide financial assistance to the families who have lost a member due to COVID-19. And for this purpose, 50,000 rupees would be given to each family who have lost their family members, okay? Question number 8. Which organization test-fired enhanced Pinaka rocket and Caliber rockets? So recently, the DRDO, that is Defense Research and Development Organization, has successfully test-fired an extended range version of indigenously developed Pinaka rocket. So 25 enhanced Pinaka rockets were test-fired at Integrated Test Range, that is ITR, in Chandipur, off the coast of Odisha. And this 122mm caliber rockets were launched from MBRL, that is multi-barrel rocket launcher. Apart from it, DRDO has also approved DIPCOVAN. And what is it? It is a COVID-19 antibody detection kit that can be used for serosurveillance for detecting the presence of COVID antibodies amongst the population. And also DRDO has recently developed single crystal blade. Actually, this is a type of technology which was purchased by very few countries earlier. And which are they? UK, USA, Russia and France. But now India also has this technology. And recently DRDO has delivered these technologies to HAL, that is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Question number 9. Which country's starter cryptocurrency accounts are named as Kivo? So recently El Salvador has announced that the country is planning to give out starter cryptocurrency accounts with $30 to promote its use. So also remember that El Salvador is the first country to make Bitcoin a legal tender. So for this purpose, the government will allocate $120 million to establish 4 million starter Bitcoin accounts or wallets which are named as Kivo or Chivo, whatever you can say. And when the law takes effect in September month, then it would not be mandatory to accept the Bitcoin, but it would be optional, according to the government out there. Also, please remember that recently, United Kingdom has banned the world's largest cryptocurrency exchanges, and now these currencies cannot be used there in UK. Also, capital of El Salvador is San Salvador. Now, coming to last question, Derek Chauvin, who was recently sentenced to 22.5 years, belongs to which country? So recently, a US court has sentenced former police officer Derek Chauvin to 22 and a half years in jail for the murder of George Floyd. and his death has created a huge outcry against racial injustice in the USA and across the world also. So earlier under state guidelines, it was just 12.5 years, but the court went beyond that and sentenced him to 22.5 years. So this is one of the longest prison terms ever imposed on a US police officer. And also remember that USA has announced to donate 500 million doses of COVID-19 vaccine to lower income countries through COVAX Alliance. And also in the February month, USA has rejoined the Paris Climate Deal because earlier it had exited from this deal. But just after 107 days, it joined it again. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide, you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video here and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section as well. So please do not cheat and be honest with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zatsana signing off.